On your own?
Am I ever out else?
There was a time.
Oh, there were lots of times. I've just been reminded of one of them.
Boyfriend?
Well, you could say that. My eldest grandson, he's just been made a petty officer.
Young Paul! Good on him.
Petty officer, eh? It doesn't seem 5 minutes since Arlinda was telling me she was going to have him.
Happy days.
Happy days? Being told you're going to be a grandma? Besides, I had enough on my plate without Dennis, without Arlinda's little trouble. And she wouldn't listen to me. Never marry a Pole, I said. They're a funny lot of foreigners.
Unless they happen to be young.
Anyway, I said, marry one of your own sort, I said. At least she'll speak the same language, but would she listen to me? It was like talking to that tabletop.
There was no wrong with Ivan.
Oh, don't blame him. It was her that was the handful. Arrived on my front doorstep, knocked on the door as bold as brass, and left him, ma'am. Devious little devil and all. Never said a word about the kid at first. Let me stew for a couple of days before I got that news.
When are we talking about?
Oh, I don't know. It was just before Christmas, I remember. Trust her. Let's see. Paul was born the following June, and he's just had his 21st birthday, so it would be just before Christmas, 1960.
Blimey, all right.
Just before Christmas, 1960. The sight of Ken Barlow, did our Dennis?
Yeah, not surprised. I can hear you now. You ought to be more like that Barlow lad.
Oh, as if he could have been.
I know, it's a bit like asking you to be a bit more like Mavis, isn't it? Not in you.
Ah, well, that's the way we're made, and that's the way we'll stop.
Are you going to have another one?
No, I don't think so. You know something about Barlow's family? The only one that died in bed of Ken's family was his dad.
Hey, that's right. His mother was run over. His brother was killed in a car accident.
First wife electrocuted, his second wife killed herself.
Oh, dear. He's had his fair share of that, lad, hasn't he? Family like that, eh?
Mm, they weren't all that perfect. Well, they might have seemed it compared with the Tanners. I can see myself now, a different fella every night. My two kids sat on the doorstep with a fish and 2 pence of the chips. And Ida Barlow running herself ragged, baking bread, darning socks, washing up at the Imperial. Do you know what brought it all back to me?
Go on.
The night the gas main broke. Remember, they shunted us all across to the mission hall. It was me with my noisy lot, and I had a Barlow clucking like it round her like a mother hen. Not 2 feet between us. Chalk and cheese.
I wasn't involved in that.
Well, you should have been. It was a good night's entertainment. Except for Ina. She made us very welcome, I don't think.
Bit thin on the ground tonight, Annie?
It's always the same, isn't it? Out of the goodness of my heart, I let Bed and Fred have the same night off. And what happens? We barely opened when poor Elizabeth gets her stomach upset.
Something she'd eaten?
Apparently. Not here, I hasten to say. And here I am, like Horatio on the bridge.
Never mind, Annie. It'll keep you out of trouble.
Which is more than we can say for you, then?
No, Annie, love.
Hey, is that right? You took your television set with you when you were evacuated.
Of course I did. The only thing we had that was worth anything.
Yeah, Harry told me he saw Ivan staggering in with it. I couldn't believe him.
Well, why not? It could have gone up in smoke. And then what would I have done with the nights? Sat staring at our Dennis? Nah, couldn't have done without my television set.
You shouldn't say things like that. You should say things like, nay, we made our own amusement in them days, you know. The whole family every Christmas standing round piano.
Piano? My family couldn't play a flipping comb and paper. Anyway, don't talk to me about Christmas. Bane of my life is Christmas.
A lot of people say that. But I enjoy them.
That's because you didn't have to stop at home and worry about what to put on the table. You spent your mornings in the pub. I never won Christmas. The whole lot of you trooping off to see a ladies' football match.
Blimey, yes. The Corinthians.
And I'll tell you when it was and all. It's the year we're talking about, 1961. I'll tell you how I remember. Harry Hewitt and me got together, got our heads together, and we persuaded Ken Barlow and his dad to come along. Yeah, their chins were still on the floor because Ida had been killed that September, and that was 61.
Yeah, that's right. I can see you now, all trooping off to that football match. Leaving me to have the usual Barney with Dennis. Christmas in the Tanners. World War III. Crackers and a box of dates. Cheers. Have you no home to go to?
An empty one.
Oh. Rita left you something?
No. No, at least I don't think she has. She's having a night out with Mavis, so that's what she says.
Oh, well, I've come to her. No harm.
Meow.
No, I mean it. No, lucky she is, Mavis. Wish I'd have had less to do with fellas.
Who are you trying to kid?
Well, when I said they'd come to no harm, I meant it. All I've ever had from fellas is toil and trouble.
You've only got yourself to blame. You had the chance and you turned me down.
You kid. You wouldn't have lasted 5 minutes. I'm telling you. We were always the best of pals. The quickest way to spoil a beautiful friendship is by getting married.
I was never a no-hoper, you know. But by heck, you picked a few of them up, didn't you?
Don't remind me, I always picked the wrong for... As if we needed reminding.
Aye.
I wonder where he is.
Don't know.
We were standing at the bar, and he was sitting there.
I was never sorry to see the back of him, you know. No, I know he was my mate, and I introduced you to him. And I wish to God I hadn't.
You don't have to stick together, you fellas. Never a word about him being married.
Didn't stop you finding out, though, did it?
No.
It hit you hard, that, didn't it?
Straight between the eyes. I can remember the exact words. Never even saw. I didn't try to.
That's right. He thought a lot of you, did Bill. He came back for you after his wife died, didn't he? And I reckon he'd have got you if it hadn't been for the other fella. I've got a lot to answer for, one way or another. It was through me that you met Ellen.
Poor little Elsie, between the devil and the deep blue sea.
And I had to stand back and say no. Crack on, I didn't care one way or the other.
You're very serious.
We're just reminiscing, love.
Oh, that's enough to add a smile off anyone's face.
It is, by gum. It makes me realise how old we're getting.
I'm certainly feeling my age tonight.
Hey, well, shall I give you a lift? Shall I do those tables over there?
What
is it? Yeah. Sit down, take the weight off your feet.
Very good. So, what were you reminiscing about, or shouldn't I ask?
Oh, there's that and other.
You know, there was a time when some of us thought that you and Len would get together eventually.
Aye, that cropped up and all. You see, we were such good pals. It would have been a pity to spoil it with a wedding ring.
Doesn't always follow, dear. My Jack and I were very good friends.
Aye, your Jack was one in a million.
Yes, I say. I've done my share of grumbling, but on the whole, I've had a very happy life.
Well, we all know that, don't we? All your secrets are revealed, remember? That night? The mission hall. This is your life.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, what a night that was.
Dear Bob, you enjoyed every minute of it.
I have never told this to a living soul, but I was petrified. I could have slain that son of yours on the spot.
I thought that was one of our Dennis's brighter ideas. At least for once he thought up something that didn't cost me anything.
Oh, but some of those people he dug up. I still go cold at the thought.
That was our Dennis, bless him. It wouldn't have been Christmas without he'd made somebody's life a misery.
And how on earth did he find that co-op milkman?
He had a great talent for embarrassment, did our Dennis. One of the few things he had a talent for. I suppose them were the best years. He was just a fool. Before he started being a fool to himself.
I wouldn't blame him too much, dear. To be honest, he was never one of my favourite young men. I never thought he was wicked. Just easily led.
Aye, and look where they led him. I never thought he'd finish up in prison.
One can never tell with boys, can they? But for the grace of God, my Billy might have gone exactly the same way.
Your Billy didn't con old ladies out of the life savings.
I can think of one old lady he conned often enough.
Oh, stop trying to cheer me up. I was just enjoying my drop of misery.
I've done all those lasses, love.
You are good. Thank you very much, Len. Now let me get you a drink. Same again?
No, don't mind.
I insist. There's time enough.
We were just talking about that time, that Christmas, when we did Annie's This Is Your Life. When was that, Mrs. Walker? You know, what we were just talking about. 1963.
We did a pantomime the following year, Cinderella.
That was another. Produced by Leonard Swindley. Pretending it was the London Palladium.
Well, the youngsters enjoyed it.
We all enjoyed it. I had a nerve in them days, kicking my legs about.
And I've had a custard pie in the face every day since.
Get off, you. You live the life of Riley.
Yeah, I suppose I've enjoyed most of it. Yeah. It might have been...
better?
Different. If you hadn't turned me down all the time.
Well, it would have been different. You wouldn't have been sitting here talking to another woman for a start.
Could I have your glasses, ladies and gentlemen, please?
Oh, well. Come on, Fairclough, back to your wife.
I've enjoyed that, you know. A little trip down memory lane.
There'll be some more. Come on, let's get gone. Good night, Mrs. Walker.
How's this, Anna?
Sleep tight, honey, love.
And you, then. My love to Rita. Come along, please. Can I have your glasses? We shall be open tomorrow.